Morning, my dear students. Welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to learn the next concept in the chapter 5 fraction. In previous lecture, we have learned to compare the two fractions or more two or more fractions. Comparison of fraction, right? We have learned to compare the fraction with same denominator and fraction with same numerators. Those two comparisons we have learned, okay, and you have solved the practice 5.3 which was based on the comparison of fraction, right? Today we are going to learn the new concept in this chapter fraction, okay, new concept, that is equivalent fraction. Now what is this equivalent fractions means? See, the meaning of equivalent fraction is in itself. What is see? Equi means what? The word equi. Equi means equi, represent equal. And valent means value. Valent means value. Equivalent means the fractions having same value. The fractions having same value. Then what is different in this? Fractions having same value, we can identify it, right? What is different in this? Why this is separate concept, equivalent fraction? Yes, why this is separate, you know? Because these fractions, equivalent fractions, they look different. Their value is same. Even though their value is same, they look different. That is why this is the separate concept, equivalent fraction, we have to learn. Understood what I'm telling? Equivalent fractions are such fractions whose value is same but they look different. So they are not easy to identify. It will look different. You will think that yes, they are different fractions, but if their value is same, then they are called as an equivalent fraction. Okay? Why they look different, or in which way their value is same? Let's see here. Let's learn that. Here also, to explain this concept, I'm going to take example of chocolate. As you know, this is the favorite thing of everyone, right? Suppose this is a chocolate. I am going to take such 4 chocolates, right? Okay. Second chocolate. Same chocolate. They are same in size. Okay, 4 chocolates I have taken, they are same in size, okay, exactly, accurately. Now what I am going to do, you know, first chocolate, I give here A, B, C and D, A, B, C, D, 4 chocolates are there, okay. First chocolate I am going to divide into 2 equal parts, first chocolate I am going to divide into 2 equal parts, okay, exactly in the half, here middle, and out of 2 equal parts, 1 part is shaded, I'll shade 1 part, okay, good. So out of 2 equal parts, first I divided this chocolate into 2 equal parts, okay. And out of 2 equal parts, 1 part I have shaded. Understood? So, here, the shaded portion of chocolate represents which fraction? If you want to express this in the form of fraction, how will you write? Out of 2 equal parts, 1 is shaded. So, it will be written as out of 2, 1. That is 1 by 2. 1 second or 1 upon 2, okay, that is also called half. So half portion is shared. Okay. Now come to the second chocolate. This time I am going to divide this chocolate into exactly 4 equal parts. How many equal parts? 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. What I have done? I have divided this chocolate into 4 equal parts. And now what I am going to do, you know, I am going to share its 2 parts. Out of 4, I am going to share 2 parts. Okay. So if you want to represent this in the form of fraction, how can we do it? In this way, how can we do it? What number will come in the denominator? Total equal parts. Total equal parts are 4. And out of 4, the shaded parts are 2 upon 4. Okay? Come towards the chocolate number C. This third chocolate, I am going to divide into how many equal parts? Can you guess? Eight equal parts. Okay? Eight equal parts. The parts are equal. And out of 8 equal parts, I am going to share first 4 equal parts. Okay? See, I have shared it. Out of 8 equal parts, I have shaded 4 parts. So, see the fraction for these shaded parts will be 4 upon 8. 8 equal parts and out of it 4 are shaded, that is 4 upon 8. Okay. Next, chocolate number D will be divided into how many equal parts? Can you guess? Yes, I am going to divide this chocolate into 16 equal parts. How many equal parts? 16 equal parts. Then can you guess out of 16 how many parts I am going to shade? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, 16 equal parts. In 16 equal parts, I have divided this chocolate. And out of 16, I am going to shade 8 equal parts. How many? 8 parts. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. So the fraction for the shaded part will be total parts are 16 and out of 16, 8 are shaded. Right? Now what I did, you know, there are 4 students. There are 4 students. Seema, Jayan, Amit and Raju. There are 4 students from my class. Okay. So, I wanted to give them chocolates. I gave 1 half chocolate, this part. Out of 2 equal part, 1 part I gave to Seema, 1 half, 1 by 2. I gave 2 by 4 chocolate to Jayan. Okay. I gave 4 upon 8 chocolate to Amit. And I gave 8 16th chocolate to Raju. So, can you tell me now who has got more chocolate? Or who has got more chocolate? I am not saying more parts. Who has got more chocolate? Can you tell me? Can you guess who has got more chocolate? Can you guess? Seema got out of 3 equal parts, only 1 part Seema got. Jayan got 2 parts out of 4. Amit got 4 parts out of 8. And Raju got 8 parts out of 16. Then can you tell me who got more chocolate? Yes, you are right. Everyone, all of four have got same chocolate. Because if you see the shaded part, all chocolates are same. Okay, all four chocolates are exactly same in size, and just the difference is what? The parts, equal part, total equal parts are different. Okay, otherwise if you see the shaded portion of each chocolate, it is same. So out of two equal part, one part I gave to Sima means this much chocolate, half chocolate I gave to Sima. Out of four equal parts, two parts I gave to Jayan means what? This much chocolate again. Same, the two parts are equal to this one part, right? This four parts are equal to these two parts, which is equal to this one part. Again, these eight parts are also equal to these three. That means what? Everyone got same chocolate. Everyone got same chocolate. We can say equal chocolate. Everyone got equal chocolate. Yes, now you will think, why this? Now you have come to know, why this 1 by 2, 2 by 4, 4 by 8, 8 by 16 are same. They look different, right? They look different. They are not same in looking. They look different, but you know that their value is same. Their value is same. Okay, so these fractions are called equivalent fraction. These fractions are called equivalent fraction. Understood why they are called equivalent fraction? They look different, but their value is same. Again, I am telling, they look different, but their value is same. So they are called as equivalent fraction. Understood? Again, see one more example I will give you. 1 upon 3, 2 upon 6, 3 upon 9, 4 upon 12. These are also the example of equivalent fraction. 1 third, 2 6, 3 9, 4 12. Okay? If you observe them, you will come to know the pattern also. Have you got the pattern? See, if in the numerator, if you see 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 1s are 1, then see 1 into 2, 2 or 1 4s are 4. See, 1 1s are 1, this is initial, 1 upon 2, okay? If to obtain this, you need to multiply this by 2, 1 2s are 2, 2 2s are 4, correct? 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, right? So this is the pattern. Or if you see the pattern in this example, 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3, 1 4s are 4, or 3 1s, and in the denominator, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12. So this is the pattern. Why this pattern comes, that also I am going to explain in next lecture. So this is the concept of equivalent fraction. Okay, 1 by 2 or 2 out of 1 out of 2 or 2 out of 4 or 4 out of 8 or 8 out of 16. All these are equal if you see in the figure. And we can show that here also. 2, you know that 2 upon 4 means 2 divided by 4. So if you divide this both numerator and denominator by same number, both are divisible by 2. So 2 1s are 2. Upon 2, 2's are 4. Again, their value is 1 by 2. Here also same. Both are divisible by 4. So, 4 1's are 4. 4 2's are 8. Again, these are divisible by 8. So, 8 1's are 8. 8 2's are 16. Their value, basic value is same. That is half. Okay? How to do this? If you don't understand, don't worry. We are going to learn that. Okay, so their basic value is 1 by 2. Though they look different, their value is same. So these fractions are called equivalent fraction. Okay, so this is is the concept of equivalent fraction. What you have to do today, on this concept, based on this concept, there is practice 5.4 that you have to solve, just this figure representation. Okay, so observe those figure and write fraction for those two figures. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.